What's up, guys? Last Humans Garage here for a quick SSD unboxing. If you follow my Instagram, you probably just saw in the last hour dual 24 twins. One has an issue I'm not going to use, so I got one brand new cherry one that's going on one of the light bars. Now, you do know I already have the Forrester light bar. You've seen that, no big deal. I'm really torn on these Forrester parts because if I put these parts on, I'm just going to live in fear with my Forrester. I'm just never going to really feel really good about it because I'll always be worrying, you know, if something happens, I'm not going to get any of that warranted. So, I mean, at this point, I'm really aiming at not putting the rest of the mods on the Forrester so I can have an enjoyable ownership and not do it just so it has all the fancy mods and big, it might give me, you know, 10 horsepower, big deal. I am running the stage one that Fat Body worked with me. We pretty much got a whole no mod tune done for the CVT, and then we were just starting over on the mods parts, super windy, when all this leak stuff hit the fan, and I kind of took everything out because I said screw this. So I have a nice stage one tune on it. It's definitely noticeable, and that's what I like right now. So I am gonna do the light bar, try and get this popped open. No, I don't even know. Now this is a WRX light bar, you know that. That's what this, oh my god, this thing is a heavy box of brackets. Workshop's getting kind of full, guys. Oh yeah, I got paint for the extra pieces of my shed too. What else did I do? Oh, let me show you a WRX snippet right here. All right, you know that, maybe you don't know, I used to have my Cobb cord coming out of that hole, which I popped out the cover. A lot of people do that, and it fits right there nicely. And then I didn't want a permanent hole always there, so I just handle it in here. The problem was, though, you know, when you have the cord out up to your port here, you can never close it. So I set up a sweet, sweet mini mod, cord mod. And it works even better than I thought. Now, you have the perfect closure. You don't have to sit there with it hanging open when you're using it. And it's a perfect small little cutout right there. Super sweet. Anyway, I'll put that back later. If you want to know, I mean, how did you do it or whatever, you just need just the most basic, the perfect round file, and just put it there and work it in and out, 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 like that. And it's just a tiny piece, but it's big enough for the cord. And that's pretty sweet. So I just always fine tune and always making it even better. Dang it. Let me get, oh, I got my razor. Now there's one big thing about this WRX SSD bar. First off, I barely know what it looks like. Everybody has the Rally Innovations. I couldn't even find one install video. Oh, okay. Very similar to the Forrester one, but the slightly different design. God damn it. Okay. Let's take a look at this puppy. Whoo! Look at that. I always love the incredible powder coating on these. I swear the SSD has like the best. Oh, first, thanks a lot to SSD. This wasn't a free part, but I got a little discount on it. So I got a nice deal. I'm pretty happy with it. So big thanks to SSD for working with me a little bit. It's a tiny company, only two guys, so you know, you can understand they can't just hand out free product all the time. But as you can see here, the Forrester one would kind of end here with these two bolts. Let me get the Forrester one. I'm trying to remember. Yeah, that's what I said. The Forrester one, I don't even want to scratch them. The Forrester one ends like that. Man, this light is bad. Hold on. Now we're cooking. See, the Forester one is right there. It's really the same exact, ooh, cool little end pieces there. I'm sure you could get replacements too if they ever get worn out. They're just pop-ins. So right, okay, so it is different. See, the Forester one has a different angle of the bar. So I don't even want to put this down and scratch it. Is that gonna fall? All right, it's a hokey video. Okay, all right. So there's one big thing I want to tell you about this bar though. I was just on track. I was saying that I searched for an install video. I always need to prepare for these. I couldn't find one. There's plenty for other cars, not for this car. The one iffy drawback to this, which I am gonna, you know, give it a shot and see what I think, you have to remove permanently your lower grill to put this in, because you're gonna have bars in here. Technically, I guess you could cut holes in it to put the bars through, but I don't even think that'll work, because you would have to get this whole piece through the bar and it's not gonna fit, right? So that's the only thing. It isn't a complete deal breaker for me. I've never really been able to get a good gloss on that anyway, and it looks even better for me right now, as I can see. There isn't a lot of exposed radiator, like mostly on this part. It's just metal. So getting a problem here. Okay. So as far as rocks and stuff, it's not that big a deal. One problem is definitely though, I do have a problem here with this design. My vinyl is just barely covered up with that grill. I'm gonna have a white line back there. I can't leave that. So is that a chip or just, if it's a chip, it'd be a perfect excuse. No, it's not. If I did keep the bar, I gotta peel off that vinyl. I'm not gonna have a jagged white line showing in the back of my bumper there. So I don't know, it's all about experiment, right? It's all about playing around. I don't know, but I do think a bar would look really killer there. I'm imagining it in my head right now. The final thing is the light issue. Let's say I was gonna put a 24-inch Nelight LED on there. Goes right in the center pieces. It's too narrow for the wide pieces, which is what I wanted. I didn't want a crazy, super ugly one. I wanted a nice, tight one. Goes about to there. So let's say I have that light, and then I have the behind the grill yellows, which I do love, but it might start to get a little bit out of control. Too many lights. Another thing is I like my stock light switch a lot. I'm gonna have to do a second switch for a second light possibly. So I'm thinking about that. I might just do a bar on this. Honestly, I'm not 100% set on a light on this one. I'm doing a light on the Forester. And finally, the sweet thing is, did this one not come with a license plate bracket? This one didn't. Dang. The Forester one came with, maybe it doesn't fit on this thing, I don't know. The Forester one came with a license plate bracket, which you can kind of, on the other side obviously, tap it in under there and relocate. I was kind of hoping to have that for this thing, but now that I think about it, it would be too low. It would be almost touching the ground. I see what the deal is. But even just for, holy shit. See my mailbox lying on the ground? Yeah, so even just for the bar, I'd do it for sure, just for the bar. Yep, that happened all right. It's the windiest day, people's garbages are in the street. There's like trees blowing down, there's like roof shingles flying everywhere across the air like a tornado. So that's all my thoughts. Give me some feedback. What do you think about extra lights? What do you think about no lights and just a bar so people don't back into me? At least my car will be protected. No grill thoughts. Peel off the lower vinyl thoughts because of that. Dual switches in the car somehow. I love my factory You can't see it. My factory switch for my yellows. Although, honestly, the yellows are purely for looks, period. Nothing else. They're just for looks. And so I'm half tempted to do away with the yellows, but then, you know, I don't know, man. Another thing would be those square yellows would not really look good on here. If I want to move them up, whatever, up to the front. Again, it would be visual. That's why you really need a bright light there. So there's a whole bunch of stuff I'm thinking about here on what fogs to keep. I want to just keep the one light switch and either run those or a new 24-inch light down there. I got a lot to think about, so I'm basically going to need all you guys to start throwing ideas around and thoughts to help me figure out my decision on this. All right, guys, that's it. It's been a 11-minute video. Don't forget my WeatherTech used WeatherTech raffle. They are packed and ready to go in here, ready to ship right away. The raffle ends in less than 24 hours now, so do go ahead if you want to have a chance at the used WeatherTech set for the 2015 to 2017 WRX, maybe the 18s, for $5. This is, I don't know what they are new, 160, 180, and I paid for those fully. I mean, I don't get a sponsor from WeatherTech. So, you know, if you want to have a chance for $5, instead of buying your coffee tomorrow, throw in a raffle ticket, see if you can get some mats if you don't have any. Otherwise, I'll see you guys later. Should be a good weekend. I'll have nice video content coming, and I'll see you then.